Hi, this is your host Dipali on Intellect Digest, and let's get started with another episode. In this video, I will share quick unboxing and hands-on review of Swipe Elite Plus smartphone. I will start with the box contents. First thing in the box is the phone itself. It comes with a USB cable, a charging adapter with output rating of 5 volts and 1 ampere, and some documentation. Now I'll talk about the build quality and design of the phone. It features a good quality plastic body with textured back for good grip. Along the sides, there are sleek silver edges which have been given a metallic look. On the front, there is a 5-inch display. Above the display, there are some sensors along with earpiece and an 8-megapixel front shooter. Below the display, there are 3 touch capacitive buttons. On the rear, there is a 13-megapixel primary camera with LED flash, secondary microphone and Elite branding. On the bottom edge, there is primary microphone along with charging port and speaker. On the top edge, there is 3.5mm audio jack. The left side of the phone is clean. Volume rockers and power button are located on the right edge. The rear panel of the phone is removable and it gives access to a non-removable 3050mAh battery, 2 SIM card slots and a micro SD card slot. Overall, it is a nicely built, compact smartphone. Now display. It comes with a 5-inch Full HD display with 1080p resolution. It is one of the few phones in this price segment to offer Full HD display. The display quality is good. It performs well in outdoors and viewing angles are also good. Coming to the camera department, it comes with a 13-megapixel rear camera with LED flash. There is also an 8-megapixel front-facing camera. Both front and rear cameras do a decent job in taking images. For a phone in this price range, the quality of images taken with both primary and secondary cameras is good. Images taken with this phone have good detailing and clarity. Moving on to hardware and performance department, the Swipe Elite Plus is powered by a 64-bit 1.5 GHz octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 615 processor paired with 2 GB of RAM. It comes with 16 GB of internal memory which can be expanded further up to 64 GB using microSD card. On testing this phone on Antutu benchmarks, we got scores of around 32,000 points. It plays light games with some ease and multitasking is also smooth, but we experienced lags and stutters while playing heavy games. Also, we faced heating issues while playing games on this phone. The temperature of the phone increased from 36 degrees to 45 degrees with just 10 minutes of gaming. Overall performance of the phone is just average and not up to the mark. On software front, it runs Android Lollipop wrapped under Freedom OS. It comes pre-installed with a little amount of bloatware. The software is smooth and user-friendly. We tested it for USB OTG and found that it supports USB OTG. Now battery and connectivity. It is backed up by a 3050mAh battery, which is good enough to last for a day on moderate usage. Connectivity options include 4G LTE, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and GPS. This phone is priced at ₹6,999. The Elite Plus does look like a decent phone in sub-₹7,000 price range. It offers Full HD display, which is not usually seen in smartphones in this price segment. Apart from Full HD display, it offers a lot of other features like 2GB of RAM, massive 3050mAh battery, as well as 4G support. But we would not suggest this phone if you're a gaming freak. If you want to buy one for yourself, then we are leaving direct links in the description section below. Please like, share and comment on this video and do subscribe for more such videos. This is your host Dipali signing off. Thanks for watching and have a great day.